Welcome back, everybody. Yeah, I know it's been a while, but if you guys been following the community channel, y'all know your boy moved from New Jersey over here to Las Vegas. And as you can see, everything's still packed up. We got the trailer over here in the RV storage lot because right now we're waiting to close on the house, so we're staying in a hotel. So I just leave the trailer here for now. But what I'm gonna do today is I'm gonna pull the jigs out and go for a little ride on it. I haven't rolled anything since that last video where I went to the track down in Alabama. So I'm gonna pull the jigs out, wipe it down, cause it's kind of dusty. It's like super dusty, actually. Look at that whole bike. So I'm gonna get her all wiped down, cleaned up, and then come back with y'all and we're gonna hit the road. Not going anywhere in particular, just gonna go out and talk about what's going on as far as the bikes go, because it's got some changes coming up. So stand by. So quick little wipe down, done. The bike wasn't dirty, it was just dusty from sitting in the trailer for like the last month since it's been out and ridden. So now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna put my pants on, find my boots, and I gotta put gas in this. I think I got some in there, so put gas in it, and then I'll get back with y'all once I get it geared up and heading out. All right, so this is like take two because I recorded the first ride when I got here on the Gixxer and didn't have no audio. Yeah, I know. And it sucked because I kind of went in like towards the evening. So the video was at night too. So without audio, it's really no reason to even post that video. So what I'm gonna do today is I just came to the base to get some gas because it's cheaper on base. And then I'm gonna go over here to the Thunderbird static display, see if I can take some pictures with it. And then after I do that, we'll go out and ride around and then just talk to y'all about, you know, the plans for the channel and what I'm gonna do. So let me make it over here to the static display and then I'll come back with y'all. All right, so as y'all can see, I got the Gixxer out today. And we're over here in front of the Thunderbird static display. I don't know if you guys know what the Thunderbirds are. I hope everybody knows who the Thunderbirds are. But this is their static display. So people come out here and they take pictures in front of it and everything. Like, I could bring the bike up here around and put it closer, which I'll probably do for the pictures. But for the video purposes, this should be good enough. So what I want to talk to y'all today about is what's been going on and why I haven't been posting as much. For those who haven't been following, you know, the post that I've been making in the community section, basically I moved from New Jersey out here to Las Vegas, which I was in Vegas before Jersey, and we came out here due to military orders. So we're back and it is hot as crap out here, and right now the housing market's bad, let's just put it that way. We lost out on two houses, and then a third one, the people selling the house tried to like get over on us pretty much. They were trying to hold offers until like the following week to get as many as they could, and then they were asking for everybody to put in their best and final offer, which I'm not playing those games. You common courtesy is 48 hours to say whether you accept or deny a offer, and they didn't do that. So that house fell through, but currently we are on the contract on the house. And as long as everything goes as planned, we should be closing sometime this week, preferably within the next 2 days. And then I can get my bikes and everything out of the trailer, because right now, as you guys could probably see if I put it in the front of this video, all the bikes are in the trailer in storage here on base. So whenever I want to ride, I have to go get the Gixxer out, which the Gixxer is the only one I can get out without moving everything else out. So we got the Gixxer, but plans for the channel. Let's talk about the Gixxer. So, fairing, sliding down a little bit right there. But as far as the Gixxer go on the channel, right now, I hate to say it, but I am actually considering getting rid of the Gixxer and getting something else. Now, the plan, the reason behind it is I don't really ride the Gixxer that much. Usually ride the H2 or the ZX10, and then for track, I take the booster. The booster's the track bike. So right now I'm back and forth about, you know, which bike or what I want to add to the channel or to my fleet. Cause honestly, guys, like, while I like that you are here for the content and for the bikes, I buy the bikes for me. And you know, if I don't like it, I'm not buying it. I'm not buying a bike just for the channel. You know, that's not gonna happen. I buy stuff because I want to buy it for me. But the options that are up in the air right now is the new booster, which kind of hard to get in the colors that I want right now. We got the S1000, which now that Woolwich can flash them, I'm all for getting one of those. And the other option was the Triple R, the Honda. So I seen one on the floor here, so that's why it's an option. I don't have to go out of state to get one or anything like that. I can probably work out a deal with these guys if that's the case. But the downside of the Honda is you can't flash the Honda right now the way that I can flash this in my work with my ZX10. I can't do it in the tuning and adjustments that I make on my bikes. So that's something that kind of steers me away from that, because I want full control over what my bike is doing and when it's doing it, and if possible be able to log what it's doing so I can adjust, you know. So that's the plans for this bike. Don't know how much longer it's going to be on the channel, or you know, how much longer it's going to be around, period, or it may stick around, who knows. Now the booster. So the booster Athena, as you guys know, it's the drag bike. So my plans for that bike is to actually build the motor here soon. Right now I'm trying to wait. I got probably one more track day. We have a Midnight Mayhem out here on the 27th, I think. So I think I'm gonna take it out there, make some passes just to see what it runs here on the West Coast compared to back there, because DA over there was like anywhere from like 500 to 2500, and then over here the DA is anywhere from like 3500 to 5000. So it's a big difference, and if I had to guess, the bike would probably, it was running 850s there. So it'll probably run like 870s, 880s here. That's my guess, but we'll see. But as far as that bike goes, we're gonna build the motor, and I'm gonna basically do it myself. I've never built a motor, but I'm gonna have somebody help me and reach out to people when I need it. But we're gonna put a nice size motor, and I'm not gonna tell you guys what size I'm going with, but it's gonna be a nice size to be able to carry me to some pretty fast times. And we're gonna start a new playlist for that bike. It's gonna be Quest for Sevens, because that's what we're after this time, is to be able to run sevens on that bike, all motor. I'm not messing with spray, as of right now at least. That's not on the menu, no spray, no boost. So that's what's going on with the boost, and I have started ordering some parts for it. Once everything get in, or as you know, bigger items come in, I'll, you know, add them into a video or whatever. So on from that, ZX10. The ZX10 is basically, I don't know, it's like up in limbo what I want to do with the bike right now. My main focus once I get in the house is getting the lights back on the bike though. So that's the main thing going on with that bike. As far as future plans for it, I was thinking about putting a swing arm on it. Not a long swing arm, probably like a 2-6 arm, just to put a little bit more length on it. And then be able to take that bike to the track or ride it on the street, and then, you know, take some more weight and stuff off of it. You know, just set it up more for, you know, drag racing and road racing. You know, out here I don't think road racing is that big, so I can't really, you know, say for sure that I want to go all out road racing when I don't even know what the scene is like out here. Granted, I'll find out. So that's for the ZX10. Now the big question that a lot of you guys have is, what about the H2? So before I left Jersey, I don't know if you guys have seen me post or whatever about it, but the H2 had an issue right before the H2 owners meet,
And what happened was I was out doing some testing, you know, trying to get the bike set up and ready for Atlanta for the HU owners meet. And I heard the bike start making a tapping sound. It wasn't a loud tapping sound, like I could barely hear it. Like, it's just when you ride the bike for a certain amount of time, you notice noises that aren't normally there. So I heard it, and I only heard it at certain RPMs and in a certain gear. So I don't know what exactly is wrong with it. I left it in Jersey with Ricardo at Motorcycle Mall. He's gonna tear it down, find out what's wrong with it. We'll get it put back together, and then when that's done, have it shipped out here and continue on our merry way. So no matter what the issue is, it's gonna be fixed and brought back to the channel as usual. But that bike has been a problem child, but she is my child nonetheless. That's the first thing I ever paid cash outright for, you know. So I don't think it's going anywhere, but I mean, you never say never, right? But as far as the channel go, that's the update. Right now my main focus is getting me and my family into this house, and then once that happens, we're in Vegas, baby. It's riding everywhere here. It's all types of videos and stuff that I can make, so I'm not worried about the content, but I just want to get everything set up at the house and ready to go, and then I'm going to start bringing you guys back to regular good God, talk about being tongue twisted, regular videos as before. So I need to find out if, you know, find some other people here that ride, you know, get somebody else that I could ride with, or guys with bikes similar, you know, because it's a lot of good places out here to ride. My cousin, as I call her, we got the same last name, but we don't show no connection anywhere that we can see on the timeline. But Keisha, she's got a ZX10, and it's got extension blocks on it. So me and her, probably you'll see us riding a lot together and probably doing some pulls against each other or whatnot. But other than that, I don't know anybody else out here that rides. So if you're watching this video and you ride, leave a comment down in the section down there, and maybe we can meet up and do some riding once I get situated. But all right, so that's the update for the channel, and that's gonna be it for now. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take some pictures of the bike, obviously the post, and then I'm gonna take the jigsaw out on the road, you know, just go do some pulls. And the reason I'm gonna do the pulls is because I need to check the logs and see what the AFR is so I can correct them. Better to do it now than wait and have the bike, you know, running too lean or too rich or whatever, and you know, end up hurting something or, you know, whatever. But I'm gonna do some pulls, get some data, make some adjustments, and then come out and make some changes. So next video y'all see, hopefully it will be me in the garage showing y'all the new setup with everything and how everything is gonna be laid out. And if I get any good pulls in, I may tag them onto the back of this video for you guys. So if you stuck around to now, here you go. You may see some nice fun stuff, or you may see the first pools out here in Vegas. So let me get these pictures and get back on the road. See if I can get a pool in. Y'all know I want first gear, so. Slow. Hey, listen, I'm just keeping it real, man. That felt slow. I'm gonna try to just hit it out of first gear and see what it does, because usually it tries to lift up at first. So about to find out. I'm gonna go up here a little bit, turn around, and do another hit. I'm willing to bet the AFR is off right now, but it feels like way off to me. Let's try this again. First gear, right? pinning it out of first and it's not even trying to lift up, so I'ma just do those two just in case it's way off. And then I'm going to make some changes and then I'll come back out again sometime and do some more pulls, I guess. COVID-19 check-in point. Oh, they preparing, ain't they? This, that place is, the parking lot wasn't even done being built. But all right, that's all I got. I'm gonna tack that onto the video from earlier. Hope you guys enjoyed those two slow pulls of me pinning it out of first gear and no wheel lift.